Hey guys, Deryck Poole here. I want to talk to you guys about appendix carry, and specifically appendix carry for us guys that are a little bit on the larger size. As a PDN contributor, I see a lot of the great questions that are sent in, and this is one that I get pretty regularly is, I'm a little bit overweight, I don't have that perfectly flat stomach, how do I appendix carry, or is it even possible? Well, in fact, it is. It's just a matter of selecting the right holster that has the right features to work for you. I can't always say this is the best one for you because it's a little bit subjective in terms of comfort, as well as, you know, your individual body type, as well as the type of gun you carry. But let's look at some of the holsters and what you need to look for in a good holster if you're one like me, a little bit bigger guy that wants the appendix carry a gun. Specifically, these holsters that I have in front of me are ones that I've actually tested and they work well for me. First, let me grab this one. This is a Dark Star Gear holster. And what you first notice is it's actually designed for appendix carry, and they've added this Raven claw on the end. What does this claw do? This claw actually fits behind your belt and will actually give a slight twist to the holster, pulling the grip of the gun in tighter to your body. One additional thing that I add to this holster is I put some Velcro on the back and add a couple pieces of foam padding. This foam padding allows the holster to touch the pelvis in front and will actually push the gun back into your body, keeping the grip tight against your stomach. These are the two areas where those of us that don't have that flat stomach need to keep that gun in tight. And these are the features that will actually do it. Some of the other holsters out there that will do exactly what you're looking for, right here I have one from Spencer Keepers of Keepers Concealment. This one actually has a hard loop and you don't see the claw on it. Well, without the claw, what he's done is, if you look at it this way, you should be able to see a slight angle on that loop. That loop is where that tucking and pulling back of the holster happens and pulling the gun back in tighter. On the back, he already sends it with Velcro here. Just grab a couple of those pads, I stick them on there, and this one works great. Also here is a Raven Concealment, their Eidolon holster. It comes with that claw feature as well, and they ship it with a hard rubber pad. I found the hard rubber pads a little bit tough for me. That's, like I said, it's subjective. You might find differently that you really like that firmer padding that pushes it back even harder. Another one I have here is a holster from Castle Bravo. This is their appendix carry rig. They have built in that claw, actually built into the Kydex, and he adds that Velcro to the rear. This one I have here is for a smaller, a Glock 43. This comes from Wingman Holsters out of Inglewood, Florida. Now, with a smaller gun, you don't run into the same issues as you do with the fuller size frames or the compact size frames. But it's a nice feature to have this little extra wing there to ensure that you're pushing it back, or if you decide to run a +1 or a +2 base plate on this gun. During this whole thing, I've actually been concealed carrying. Right now, I'm carrying a full size Glock 17 just to show you that it is possible to hide the gun. Right now, when I pull this one out, what you can see is it has a wing on the end and it has that foam padding. This again is another holster from Wingman Holsters as well, one I've just started testing out. So guys, get out there, girls as well. If you want to give appendix carry a try, it's very possible to do it. Check out one of these holster makers, or when you find your favorite holster maker, go check and see if they provide these features for you. Thanks a lot and see you on the range.